Well, we got our snow plow guy down in the ditch pretty good here on Lakeland Drive. He's down in there pretty good. Got this big flatbed tow trailer here, gonna try to pull him back up out. I can't believe people are out trying to drive around in this. This guy's okay. He was here at 6:30 in the morning is when he went in the ditch. Right now it's probably about 11:30 or 12 in the afternoon. And then a car just came downhill and went around the wrecker, and their tires were just maybe a few inches from dropping off into this deep ditch.
Yep. That's
looks like they're gonna get it here. We'll see what happens.
Bring their big one out.
Well, they decided that the tow truck is not beefy enough to pull that wrecker out. Gonna need a heavy wrecker. He's down in there good. We'll give you an update when we know more, but these guys with the wrecker can't do it. They're giving him the bad news right here. Well, this is interesting. Got this big rig here. Gonna try to lift the back end of the truck in the ditch. And then they put this truck with the ass end in the ditch. And that ditch is 3 or 4 foot deep, and they got a winch on that. I gotta see how this works. Gotta show this to Matt's off-road recovery. See how he thinks about this technique. I'm gonna get back. These cables be snapping and stuff here. Interesting. We'll find out here in a minute how this works. Uh-oh, he's rolling. See how this goes here. All right, I'm gonna go around this side. Get a close up of this deal here. I don't know about this. I don't think that thing's got enough oomph to pick that thing up. We'll find out, I guess. It lifts lots of block up high on the buildings. That's what it is. Both these guys are from masonry companies, and these are all their vehicles they use for masonry work. We're gonna find out here in a minute here. It's coming up a little bit. I'll be done. Hope them hydraulic cylinders are up to the task here. Interesting here. Alright, they're lifting out about a 1,400 pound bag of sand off the back, which makes sense first. I'm gonna show this to Matt's off-road recovery out in Utah. They don't work in this kind of snow, I don't think, though.
You ever heard of Plan B from Utah?
Yeah, that sounds familiar.
They build all the big apocalypse trucks and everything.
Oh, maybe I haven't been.
They build the big off-road campers and all that stuff, you know, out of military stuff.
Okay.
We sold them to Utah.
Oh, okay.
This is what they build. They build this extreme weather, extreme stuff, you know. Matter of fact, I wish I had it still. We sold them a 10-ton record, a 5-ton record.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I had a winch in the front, winch on, you know, the back.
I watched Matt's channel out there, and they this time of year, they switched over to a snow cap with track device to get these guys out from where they're stuck up there. And then they go back down to the desert where they live.
Yep. Yeah, a friend of mine at Wolf Law's got a snow cap.
Here we go. I think they're going to try to back the crane up and pull it up onto the road here. Here it comes. Holy mackerel, the driver had to bail out of the lift. That was almost nasty. That front wheel's off the ground 18 inches. Holy mackerel. Looked like it was going good. I don't know why that front wheel's not coming down. Did it break something? Is that the way the frame can twist like that? They're coming down now. I would just pull it backwards from this point here, probably. I don't know. He's turning the wheels kind of crazy here. The guy undoing the strap right now is a preacher at Anchor Baptist Church, and that's his lift. He's coming to help Rogers Masonry. They're both in the masonry business, so it's another masonry company coming to the aid of the other masonry company. Because there ain't no way they would get a wrecker with a boom here today. See what they got planned now. All right, we're getting it now. They're pulling backwards. pulling backwards now. That inner wheel is almost up on the pavement there. Almost. There. I think he's got... There, his back wheels are on. I think he can just reverse himself back onto the pavement from here. Man, I wouldn't stand there where that guy was standing. He was between the bed of the truck. What do you say, Luther? Well, something happened to this last video clip. The audio was missing, and it was at the wrong speed, so I slowed it down. All I wanted to show here was that the front wheel had rolled, the tire had rolled off the rim in the ditch side there, so they had to take one of the back tires off because it was a dual axle and put it on the front to get this done. And that's it.